Happy Valentine! Welcome to the show. I am Moriah Afolabi Brown. Today we have all the ladies in the building.
All the ladies.
Except for Waike. How you guys doing?
We're doing amazing.
10 seconds. How? What's happening? What's happening? Oh. Life is your hand. This is your kitty.
Thank you.
It's like you're coming straight from. You and Nima are coming straight from Northern Africa.
Yes, sir.
What's happening?
It's Valentine, so I want to wish everybody happy Valentine's Day, whether you have a boo. Or you don't have a boo, or your boo has a boo, or your boo doesn't have a boo.
Okay.
Happy Valentine's Day. Be happy, stay safe, that's all. So I sent Oga gifts yesterday, shocking.
And so only you on this table bought gifts. Marianne, did you buy gifts? So we've not bought gifts for our spouses.
No, we don't do Valentine.
You don't do Valentine.
Yeah. I've received, though.
You've received.
You received? Yeah. Wow. Yeah, sure. Some of us are still expecting. Because the thing was, go and buy, and I'll pay you back. The money to buy safe, I have to gather it first. How are you doing, Nima?
Selling rice.
You're still selling rice?
Yes. So I have deliveries to do today so that I may car. I'm not stopping at my office, just straight to deliver and sleep. I need to sleep. Tomorrow is inter house sport.
Oh, yeah. All right.
So that's real life after this.
Yeah, yeah. Life happens. Life happens after
that. Always real life.
She's taking part in 3 sports.
Oh,
the brother is busting balloon.
It's something, it's activity.
So I'm looking forward to it. Okay. She told me, Mommy, you have to be there. The sacrifice, everything. So.
Fantastic. Mariam, how are you doing?
I'm fine. So, just quick one. We need to talk to Lagosians when they cross the major highways, especially when there's a pedestrian bridge right before you. So, especially around that Onipan, because I ply that road when I'm coming to work. There are lots of people who instead choose to cross the road instead of using that pedestrian bridge that is right there. Right. I don't know the state of the bridge, but when you're driving over, because today I had to check to find out why. It looks like it's falling apart from the bottom. Right. I don't know what the top looks like, but it's so scary to see a parent with 2 kids, school bags, trying to cross that road when all the cars are just flying past. So please, let's learn to use the bridges.
Hi, Dintokwe, I like our clothes.
Yes.
What's
winning today?
I need more sleep. I'm expecting gifts. I need a bit of loving at the moment. I'm just overworked. Yeah, so it's just plenty work, but we can't complain. We're grateful to God.
Gifts. I've not gotten any gifts.
No, Mariam has got
a gift. I got a gift this morning.
Yes.
She smart gave me a gift this morning.
Yes.
She gave me the. And interestingly, you'd be surprised. She's actually doing something very interesting. Where about 10% of the profit that she's trying to sell about 1,000 pieces of this.
Okay.
So 10% of that is always go to helping kids.
And I think
school,
like 1,000 children will get school
Sorry, it's not
uniform.
School uniforms. Not school, it's school uniforms.
So for every one outfit you buy, one child gets a uniform for the next session.
Well done, Steve.
Give us this stuff. Thank you so much, Steve. I really appreciate it. I mean, it's a lot of work she's doing there. And
we need to encourage businesses to do that. Yeah.
Anyways, we're going to go on a break now. When we come back, we go through the front pages of the newspaper. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Forgot to thank Cream Slices for the lovely cake. Every time. And they said it was a beautiful Valentine cake today. Really appreciate that. Let's start with The Nation. Leon out, Diri hopeful, as INEC reviews judgment. IG Southwest governors unite on Operation Amotekun. Flight diverted as weather grounds airlines operations. Lassa fever death toll hit 70. 472 cases in 26 states. Rain of tributes for High Life musician Olaiya. Ajimobi sues Makinde over land revocation. Okay.
You got 2 stories down? So,
you haven't taken? Unemployed figure. unemployed figure hits 23 million. Wow. Mm-hmm. More Cameroons flee into Nigeria over the violence.
So let's
start with the Lassa fever.
Lassa fever. Yes. So according to the Center for Disease Control, we have our Lassa fever deaths has increased to 70. And we're out of the 470 something cases that we have, and there are still more cases under study. I quickly want to link this to the story of the federal government by the Minister for Science and Technology promising every scientist in Nigeria who can provide the cure for coronavirus 36 million. We have local indigenous viruses plaguing our people as well. We should take as serious what is local as we take what is international seriously. Coronavirus is peculiar to China, and they are on top of it. Imagine them building hospitals in how many days to meet their school. So we should please You see, this is service kind of thing.
We joined that global bandwagon for those issues. But when it comes to localized, when
the Chinese people made it easy by sending you a template of how to deal with the issue.
To deal with it, yeah.
What we haven't done is
we never even studied our own to send.
Yeah, so we need to localize our.
If you can present a cure for Lassa fever, I'd like that the 36 million.
Okay, let's talk about the
unemployment.
Unemployment.
Yes. So the National President's Nigerian Association of Chambers of Commerce, Industry, Mines and Agriculture, NASIMA, yesterday mentioned that Nigeria's unemployment has hit 23 million. It was 3.5 million people in 2010. But by 2019, according to the NBS, it has reached 23 million. And he's saying that there's a deficit in graduates with talent. So they had a program where they trained about 316 graduates in training them on other aspects of technology. Okay. So they are saying that these ones are ready to be introduced into the workforce. But the problem is now you have trained them, but there are no jobs ready for them. It's unemployment we're talking about here. So it's not about them churning out. We have a lot of them graduating, but there are no factories, there are no companies for them to get into.
Right.
So we need to look
moving
into
on
that.
To the punch. Uncertainty surrounds Bayelsa as governor. Supreme Court sacks APC Leon. Four arrested as Yoruba Hausa clash in Ogun. Subscribers must explain need for new mobile lines, says minister. Again, gunmen kill 7, injured 5 in Kaduna attack. Oyo revokes Agodi Jericho GRA land, Ajimobi fumes. Activists varsity expels 6 students for cultism. Southwest governors and his inspector general adopt model for Amotekun. 4 directors arraigned for fraudulent 2.5 billion euros. Whoa, refinery projects. And 1999... 2003 elections results missing, says INEC. Wow. Okay, should we do Leon right now because of time? We have very little time. Go ahead.
Okay, so yesterday the Supreme Court in a very, very landslide judgment because there was no dissent. Unanimous decision, you know, reversed the candidature of the APC and, you know, and compelled INEC to give to the next highest votes that reflects...
That has
the necessary spread across the state. So the PDP, of course, they are having the party believing they are the ones who won.
But there are controversies.
That is not the issue. My Lord Justices of the Supreme Court, you know, of course, again, relied on the fact that the candidate of the APC in the governorship elections lacked merit. This person has... issues about his results, and the issues of the results had been...
So both the candidate
been
and the deputy.
...upheld at the High Court that he didn't have proper results. So this person has different names from his primary school, secondary school, university, about 5 certificates with different personalities, and to which he went and swore affidavits to just one of the... to the results saying that I'm the same person. These things don't work like that. I don't understand how the highest age you leave primary school will be 14. How you're qualified to do an affidavit for that.
The irony of that was that...
Was it that APC didn't do this due diligence before?
My sister, that's the problem. So the APC chairperson, whoever did the screening, because these forms were paid for, and where was the screening? I don't understand how they would take such a person.
I was going to take one more story.
This one where everybody has
the directors of Petrol Union and Oil and Gas Limited, 4 of the directors have been arraigned for an alleged scam, which is they were able to procure a check from Barclays Bank for that was about 2.5 billion euros, claiming that they had some amount with Central Bank, about 2.1 euros, and they claimed that they wanted to use this money for building refineries and things like that. But according to AFCC, it's alleging that this is a scam and it was a fraud, and so they have been arraigned, and we'll see how this goes.
This will not stop legitimate companies from getting funding.
Imagine.
Moving on to Vanguard. Confusion in Bayelsa as Supreme Court sacks the governor-elect. I know he was actually rehearsing for his inauguration.
Right. Mm-hmm. Very, very...
It's just painful. When you associate with people of such, you know...
It rubs
enemies
upon you.
At the gates.
Eventually.
Ready for your enemies.
I think we should people should start to have integrity with the kind of association
anyway, Richard, let's move on. Nigeria's food import deficit valued at 1.1 trillion naira in a year, says Nevin. Edo 2020, Obaseki Ezeyamu, EPM, Beaker, over calls for surveillance on group people. Let's talk about this deficit.
So Dr. Andrew Nevin is the chief economic partner at PwC West Africa, and he gave this statement saying that Nigeria imported food worth 1.4 trillion in 2018, and what we exported was barely 302 million naira, which means that we're heavily dependent. That's the deficit of 1.1 trillion. So we definitely need to improve our agriculture. Currently, agriculture constitutes 25% of our GDP, and we should do more if we're considering diversifying from oil-based country.
Okay. Moving on to Daily Trust, suspense over Supreme Court. We talked about that. Let's find it a story we haven't taken. David Leon suffers Koguna's fate. Yeah. Find coronavirus cure, get 36 million naira. Wow. IGP Southwest Governors agree on Amotekun. 1999-2003 election results missing, says INEC. And insecurity, people must be sacked for failure. That's Lawan spitting fire in Senate. I mean, I thought that. Yeah. I mean, interestingly, the Senate president has actually impressed me in the last few weeks. He's been quite consistent. And obviously he's insisting that people must lose their jobs if they're not doing the right.
So we want to see that happen.
So, not just let's take a few stories there. Which one did you want to take? I thought it was
the Leon story, but yeah, we've sort of taken it.
Amotekun.
Who has the Amotekun story?
Yes, so finally, everything has been arranged. The southwestern states, about six of them, and the Inspector General of Police are on the same page concerning Amotekun right now. The legal framework is out and ready, and they are saying that it's not going to work as a regional security outfit, but it's going to be in individual states that will be monitored, more like community policing, so to speak. So we're looking forward to the success of it.
Okay, very quickly to the Guardian, let's find a story. Nigerians in China seek evacuation over coronavirus. Who has that story?
I have the story. So Nigerian students in China are complaining, saying that since this outbreak of coronavirus, they have been writing to the foreign affairs minister that they want to be evacuated, like other countries have. Egypt and some other countries have come to evacuate their people. But they said so far they've not heard anything. But then that department is saying that the Nigerians there do not have the disease. They have not been affected, so to speak, and they are doing well. But they are complaining that they are not able to really go out. Schools are about to resume very soon for the students. They are not able to go out and do businesses. They will be needing resources very soon because they are more like confined in several areas.
So embassy cannot do anything for our citizens that live in China? Is that what this means?
Exactly. We haven't heard anything from them.
Moving on to News Direct. Wow. Tension in Bayelsa State, like we talked about Bayelsa story already. Let's find a story we've not taken. Fuel scarcity looms in Lagos, Ogun State over NSC Nupeng dispute. Infrastructure development key to economic growth. FIIRO crisis. Union holds mega rally to end series of protests. Sokoto State Director in ICPC net over fake scholarship letters. Man 42 beats his wife to death in Benue. Can you read News Direct? But I know that the story on fuel scarcity. Who was that story? Yes, Nima.
So they said there's a dispute between the Nigerian Customs Service and the National Union of Petroleum and Natural Gas Workers, NUPENG, in Ogun State due to the border closure. So, yes, due to the border closure, petrol stations within the Badagry axis up until Agbara have been shut down, and it happens like that to reflect in Agbara, Sango, all the environs, states, areas around the border have been shut down. And this, of course, has increased the suffering of the people. So when you get to Badagry, you have to get to Ajara, where you find only two filling stations, and the queue is endless because the federal government is trying to curtail smuggling of petroleum products across the border. And this has affected people. Now, the Nupeng is saying that the customs seized a tanker that, you know, sort of drove mistakenly across that line, and then they took the tanker to Ikeja where they sold the products. And the customer has denied entirely having any knowledge of what they are talking about.
Moving on to Daily Sun, our last paper, confusion, tension, rain in Bayelsa. Anxiety no more here as Nnamdi Kanu buries parents today. Politicians paid miscreants to boo Buhari in Borno, since presidency. Insecurity, Lawan blows hot, says enough is enough. I mean,
as Garba Show is saying, see, when the president came from the airport, he was greeted by people who were saying thank you for coming. And by the time he was leaving, there were people on the streets booing him. And they're alleging that some of them said that some politicians called them aside and gave them money to boo him. But I don't think that's what is important here. What's important is that our president needs
to be under attack.
Yes. And the governor is saying they need to change the strategy in the way that they are fighting this war. They need to be more offensive, take it to the hideout instead of having these situations where they just come
the president of the Senate.
For the presidency not to be defensive.
Please stop emotionally responding. People are actually dying. And it's provocative enough for people to want to respond. Whether they boo you by payment or not.
Miscreants, I didn't know.
So the booing, please look look into the issues.
They must not even
had an investigation of what's happening now, presently.
So before we have another crisis in the Southeast, let's just beg the security officials, our police, the military, everybody that's going to be around the burial of the Kanu burial, please.
Let's keep the
let
peace.
Let there not be any misfiring or any attack. Under no circumstances should anybody get shot at this occasion.
Schools are closed. We have to wrap up on this. That's all we can take on Front Page Review. When we come back, we have quite a few topics to discuss. It's Valentine. We're celebrating. We'd like to hear your thoughts on how would you like them to treat you this Valentine's Day? Call your husband to watch TV right now because he just might get some ideas. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. Your View will be right back. Welcome back to Your View.
Thanks for staying with us. Everyone loves a surprise. The whole idea of a wonderful, pleasant surprise is to do or give something unexpectedly. So in this season of love, we're asking, how do you expect to be surprised by your spouse or your partner? You can join the conversation 070-80-66804. You can also tweet to us at TVC Connect. Please hashtag YourVTVC so we can read your tweets. I was asking the producers, because I had posted a video last weekend, and I was asking my husband for a gift. You know, I wanted a new hair because I think I've exhausted all the hair that I have. And the guy was so unromantic. You know, I was asking, we were in the car, coming from a party. You know, and I was asking him and thinking that he would at least be, Kilo Fe Gongo, now what do you want? Tell me.
My darling.
It's not about, everybody saying that I should appreciate the fact that at least he said he would give me something. Mm-hmm. That's not the part. The part
he
is,
wanted that.
How? What do you want exactly? And honestly, I'm like, I want this. Oh, really? How much is it? Okay, let's, you know, there's a way, there's something that eye contact does.
Moraya, you said it yesterday. There's something that women want respect and to be understood. It's not about the value of what you're buying. I think most men don't get it. In our culture, I pity the men because they're actually brought up to feel the weight of the responsibility of financially providing. That they don't understand that for the women, it's more about the emotional connection. So you might say, my babe, I cannot buy you that hair, but I have something else. But that will make you feel all the love that it gave you that connection. Yet you're not willing to buy and you still feel like, thank you, but you're wanting more. The expectation of emotion is not communicated to the men enough for them to understand that this is
like
how to
like the emotional
meet
part
so,
of it.
So my own is that this video is sort of like a scam, a setup. People have gone out the whole day and you're on your way and you're in traffic. Please give this guy a rest.
We're not in traffic, the car was moving next.
Okay, it was moving, whatever. I'm just saying that there are different scenarios. Yeah. Imagine maybe that conversation had happened another time.
They explained the situation. The guy was Africa romantic.
So let's
that's
say
Africa
another
romance. Give you, you want to buy hair, buy it. Paid. Simple. That's African romance.
I told the producers to actually play. They're going to try to see if they can find it because they don't have an idea what they're talking about.
Going back
to how we want to be treated this Valentine, because the truth is that women have expectations. Yes, you can call it Oyinbo holiday. Calm down. You can say Oyinbo holiday is not African. But whether we like it or not, love is love anywhere in the world. Mm-hmm. What is love is that word that from where it starts to where it ends, it means exactly the same thing. So how do we want to be loved this Valentine? What are the nice? I'm not starting with you anymore. I'm not talking to you.
I'm not talking to the
Ajibu. What are the nice? So how do we want to be loved? Especially the men watching us right now.
Yeah.
They don't know how to show that love to their spouses.
Okay.
How would you advise them?
Women are soft beings.
Right.
You know, we're made from the rib of the man.
Yeah.
You know, he was sleeping. He's a crude one. He was sleeping. They took out one rib and they formed us. So
this
we're made from finished products. And because of that, we like good things. We like to be pampered. We like to be handled with care.
Yeah.
We like to be paid attention to those little things. Yeah. Your eyelash, your cheek, your nose.
Oh my God.
Babe, you look amazing today. Down to your fingernails. We love to be paid attention to. So it's not just about the money. And that's why I've seen a lot of women who have money. Their husbands have money. But then they are still doing other things because that attention, that care is not there. So the Nigerian man needs to get to a point where they understand that my wife needs
my attention. My wife needs that quality time more than the money. The money is the icing on the cake. The money makes it sweeter, you know? But then that attention is what we need. And we understand that you people are stressed most of the time. You go to work, there's traffic. You're thinking of family and all of that. But that little time you have, because some of you who have side chicks, you give them that time now. They rub your head. They hit you like this and say, stupid boy. And then you laugh. But then when you come home, you have the man and so we want that kind of attention. For me, when it comes to things like this, I don't talk too much because I have it on a daily.
Thank you. Okay, Mariam, what are you how do we advise? Like, not only men, also women.
Even women.
You should actually treat your spouse. You should actually make him feel loved too. Mm-hmm. It's both ways, actually.
And I love that you asked me that particular question because my husband has always been quite romantic when it comes to days like this.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
He's always the one you wake up in the morning and there's flowers waiting for
you.
So I always get that, but I just never feel like I'm doing enough for him. So at Christmas, his own gift was the only one under the tree. I went out of my way and I got in a box. He was so happy. I was like, wow, Santa came to see me this year. So my plan, my own goal is to find ways to make this man feel special. Aww. I'm not saying he's
so
the
sweet,
most fantastic man in the world. You know, you have your whatever, but he's my perfect man, you know. And I want to show that appreciation. So, and he doesn't ask for anything. He just wants you to be there. He wants you to work out. So you look like an athlete. But, you know, he just likes that communication. Connect. And he's always pushing me to be a better person. So how do you give someone who really doesn't ask for anything or doesn't really need anything? My dream is that one day I'm able to buy him a beautiful Range Rover. Aww. He comes downstairs and he opens the door and then
he's
there. That's my dream.
Hey, it's lovely. I'm telling you, baby. Okay, I think I have a call. Good morning. Are you there? Happy Valentine's Day. Hello?
Hello? Hello?
You're live. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, good morning there, Morayo.
Yes.
Yeah.
So how are you treating your spouse?
Good morning to the ladies in the house.
Good morning.
I don't know why you people have decided to put men under pressure these days.
I'm on your side, though.
You're putting the men under pressure.
Hey.
But there's Valentine always now. We have been having a Valentine love all the time. Why
a special day?
A day like this? Why a special day? Okay. And today, for me, a lot of things will go wrong. Today, a lot of things will go wrong today.
Don't
you think about that?
Why?
Like what?
We reject it.
Let him land.
Like what?
Like what, sir?
You see ladies expecting gifts from the husband, putting the man on pressure to get me this, get me that, I want this. But you have not asked about what the man, what would the man get?
We're talking about it, sir.
Okay, we're asking, so
what would you like?
What would you like, sir?
Nothing special, but at least show the men that you are trying.
Okay.
We are trying.
Thank you very much, Chidi. And I think, you see, men have a way of using this day to say, you know, it's not about celebrating Valentine's Day on one day.
Yeah, every day
should be like, we know that. Don't come with that. We know that. We are saying today is Valentine.
I really hope that Mr. Mark is watching this.
Yes,
because,
please, Mr. Mark.
You know, it's 10 years on this journey.
Hey!
And every time. And every time is to say, I'm loving you every day.
Mm.
So why do we have to make a big deal out of Valentine's Day? And then I will hear the history of Valentine's Day. And now it is a commercial enterprise. And how they just do.
Oh, I agree with him.
But you see, the thing is that while I agree that it's very commercial, a lot of businesses are balling right now. Even his business is balling because people are ordering phone for their loved ones and all of that. And I get what Trudy is saying, that there's so much pressure and the desire to live up to the expectation. I think that we should cut our coats to the material available for both parties.
Thank you.
No woman should expect the man to do more than his
to
pocket can
his
afford.
Thank you.
And no man should expect the woman to do more than the pocket can afford to. So when I woke up, when I was telling my husband on Monday, I said, see, I'm very, very easy. Very, very easy to get to. I'm a foodie. Just bring food.
Ice cream.
Yes.
Get me the ice cream. Get me that nuts that they sell in our supermarket. Salt. Mixed nuts. I say, and just put, you know, a cream, you know, those cream alcoholic
small.
And then we'll do the other room. We're good. That's all.
Yes,
I say, it's very easy.
I like him, my sister.
I'm not asking. Yeah, if you now feel like you can add iPhone 11 Pro on top, we will not. I will not finish you
in the other.
I will finish. You know that kind of thing.
So can I
but
talk?
It's easy.
Okay, because let us give
Moraya has shut me up on this thing.
Okay, Elijah is looking for Abala.
So please, no, don't say that. So I don't do Valentine, but I do my wedding anniversary. Mm-hmm. And my husband likes to spend, but I like to cook. Mm. So everything I do, even my children, I do it inside the house. So madam, if you are watching, be happy from inside. Don't wait until somebody come and make you happy. If Valentine means a lot to you, prepare for it, create the ambience, invite your husband, love him, and love your family and enjoy life. Don't look at your neighbor that collected iPhone Pro 11 and be yourself, because you see this life is not that hard. You can be happy. And our men, they're Africans. They know that gifts, money, is what they can speak. Mm. The cocoa is that the scene landed your account. It doesn't matter whether there was a poem that followed it. Please, stop living in Z world and telling Mundo.
But you see, let me tell you,
I will seriously agree with you here. You see this romance thing? Now, overrated, you call him now. It's really overrated. No. The man knows it is important. An African man knows it is important that you are not lacking anything.
Yeah.
Mm. He is not lazy. He's pushing his back. He's making sure your kids are not outside, sleeping outside or hungry.
Yeah.
So, please,
he's responsible. Okay,
take that seriously.
Good morning. Are you there? Happy Valentine's Day.
Good morning. My name is Sarah.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi, Sarah.
I'm a first-time caller.
Woo!
Good morning. I also really appreciate my husband today. He really surprised me.
What did he do?
It was like, maybe take this money, get some good bras for yourself. I was like, just get something for yourself. Make sure you get a good brand.
Thank you.
I was so happy. I wasn't expecting
that. Nigerian man representing.
Fantastic. So that's a Nigerian man.
Yeah, he's representing.
See, Mariam said she wants to get a Range Rover for her husband. I want to also do that one.
Yes, we're holding her together for
he
this.
He just wants, like, go and work out, get this good shape and all that. But I just feel one day I will get him something that he has been expecting from nobody. I will give it to him as a gift. Mariam, I'm behind you.
I'm behind you too, sis.
Have a nice day.
You too.
I've always said, share this story. That while I was single, I don't think I ever really received any Valentine gift, because I meet my boyfriends after Valentine and we break up before Valentine.
Your case
so different. I have never that received in my life. When I now got married, the very first, no, I think while we were dating, my brother-in-law's girlfriend at the time made sure my husband came back. She went to go and buy everything, the cake, the wine, everything, and just gave it to him to deliver. So he even had an idea. So, but since marriage, I've not really received anything.
Mm.
Because I'm not the gifty type of person. Yeah. But you know, sometimes I know my husband tries to make an effort too. Because I know what I want is a good, nice dinner.
Yeah.
Take me to a nice, classy restaurant where we order nice.
But yeah, some
men, Nigerian men cannot understand why would you spend big money.
You know why this is even important?
For dinner.
You know, because of the way the economy is, everybody is working. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you realize that you have not even had a conversation with your husband in a long time because we are rushing back home, everybody's tired, you are eating, you are going to bed, the kids, the bills, and all of that. So on days like this, it's more like a reminder that we should keep that fire. So it's not like we're trying to put pressure on the men. The little things you do matter. It's not about giving me the big money to buy the hair and all of that. I have not given my husband a gift in a long time. So this time around, I decided to surprise him. And I was unfortunately asking for his address to the office. I said, why are you? He doesn't like surprises. Why are you asking for my address? I said, just give me the address. So yesterday, I sent the first batch of gifts to him. I was like, hey, you've already given yourself. I saw it. The lasting side cheek. Oh. I said, did you open the gift? He said, yes. So today, another gift is on the way to him. Just to make him, because the truth is.
To say something.
Yeah,
one of the things I realize is that sometimes also, you know, I started by saying that we put a lot of pressure on men, and the African man's responsibility is just to take care of the family.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's all that is in mind. But another thing that I learned from Tara and Fela Drotoye couple is that help your spouse understand what you want.
Mm.
Help your spouse so that they don't come to the house and give you a phone when what you want is a bra.
Yes.
Or you give them boxers when what they want is a perfume.
Mm.
So lay the foundation like a week or a month before.
Talk
you know what
it.
Will make me happy this Valentine? And then you drop it.
Mm.
So the person knows what
you're
doing.
Can I give one example? When I was dating my husband, there was also...
I think I'll call. Another example. Ajiboye, are you there?
Okay.
Ajibola.
Thanks
for calling. Go ahead, please.
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
God bless you. Happy Valentine.
Happy Valentine's to you, sir.
Yes. God bless you.
Bless you too.
Yeah. Today is Valentine. You know, this. I'm beside my wife now.
Oh, sweet. So,
yesterday, what I did was that something she's been asking me for the past 3 weeks, I've been dodging doing like that. I said, let me just bring this thing no more. Mm. You know, she called me yesterday for something at work. I said, you people go and get it. When I get home, we discuss it. When I was coming, I just brushed it, get those things. I brought it home. You know, she didn't say thank you. She said, but you told me that I should go and get it myself. I brought it. She left that in there now. I'm still looking at it. You know, this morning I say, good morning. We have to. Today's Valentine now. You know, though I don't think there should be a special day for this. You know, we should continue to appreciate each other.
Yeah. Mm? Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much.
So let me join. I was going to give an example. When I was dating my husband, I remember one time he gave me a wristwatch, and there was also like someone else interested as well, and that person also gave me a wristwatch.
Okay.
See, the other person gave me this nice leather wristwatch with stones on the cover. It was more beautiful to me than the one my husband gave me. You know that that leather wristwatch did not last 6 months before it started peeling. But that one that my husband gave me many years ago is still brand, it's still good, and I get to wear it up till now.
That's
the
original.
At the time that he gave me, it just didn't seem trendy enough. So it's just like a message that sometimes where you are,
glitters.
It's not always gold. It's not always gold.
You know, what I was telling my story earlier, I was driving home to the point that now my husband has been disturbing me for the past few days. That where should I take you for this Valentine? And I've been so busy too. I couldn't even settle my mind.
You see yourself?
So I'm now thinking to myself that, okay, so sometimes we need to pay attention. Mm-hmm. Because he knew that, okay, I've always wanted to go out to dinner. Mm. It's asking me, well, my mind was not settled enough to say,
I want
to go to ABC. It was now to this moment, I said, hey, you're talking about where can we go?
Your story is very interesting because we've been together on this matter for like almost 7 years now. And I know when Mariah will come on the show and say, I just want to dine. And people should learn from this story because sometimes what you want, your marriage isn't ready for it. Mm-hmm. Your life isn't ready for it. And if you would just wait, it would happen. You just casually ask yourself, I want to buy her. Say, buy it, I'll pay you.
Yes.
But that wasn't the story before.
Yeah.
You know, and people don't want to know that sometimes these things take time. And you keep watering that ground.
Yes.
The marriage might not give you her. It might not buy you a car now. You know, but water that ground. And tomorrow, it just might happen.
Yeah, so true.
When I think I have a call, then I come to your name. I know you're holding. Good morning, are you there?
Hello.
Thanks for calling. Go ahead, please.
Good morning, lady.
Good morning.
Happy Valentine's Day.
You ladies are doing wonderful work.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Bringing to the fore some things that Nigerians need to know, especially as it concerns Valentine's Day. I think you should educate Nigerians what Valentine is all about. It's not only love on the Valentine's Day. It should be everyday thing. It should be everyday thing.
Okay.
Not you show your wife love today, tomorrow there's no love. Like the last man spoke, he bought a gift for the wife and the wife did not even open it, he left it there.
Ew.
And there's more pressure on men than women. Mm-hmm. I think it will be balanced.
Thank you. We're balancing it here.
I have to go on a break, I think. When we come back, we'll take a... Okay, I think I can actually take your comments.
So I wanted us to value the small things.
Stay tuned. Your View will be right back. Welcome back to Your View.
Welcome back. So we're still celebrating Valentine's Day and we're still asking, how do you like to be mesmerized today? What would you like your spouse to do for you today? Nima.
So me, I usually look where people go look. I look at the odd places. So I said to my husband this morning as he was getting ready for work that aside to you, I love you a lot from Imran as my second child. Very spontaneous. just comes, oh, mommy, I love you. Aww. Sometimes you come, mommy, you need a hug. And it will be at the right moment, and it will give me a hug.
God sent.
And then sometimes it will come, mommy, I want to sleep on you. Usually, I want to cuddle you. That's what it means. And he cuddles me. And I'm like, aww. Baba. You see, you need to learn a lot from this boy. Because he does it spontaneously. My husband does a lot of I love you. At least I can get up to 12 per day.
Uh-uh.
Every day.
Wow. Your emotional bank is full.
It's over full. But my son, at his age 3, spontaneously just looking at me and tell, yesterday night when he did it again, I hugged him right back because I actually was very tired to my feet. I needed it. But the other sister, she just
passed. Nima, you see, the thing is, love is what our children, and I'm happy I use
it.
They sense it, but then as they grow up, we weed out, we quell the emotion. We use words to say, you're being too soft. Mm. So your husband might naturally default be like a man.
Mm.
But it has to man up over time, man up. So we need to encourage it.
Look at the mirror ourselves, because I know that some of these emotions we experience, we can learn from our experiences.
Yes, I've learned
from I know that in the beginning of my marriage, I got a lot of I love yous, a lot of hugs. And I was so, I kind of pushed. I was like, really? But then, no, after a while, it just didn't happen again.
And that's what I think.
So that's what we need to begin to, what are we doing
yes.
to quell
yeah.
our spouses?
Or encourage
our spouses' emotions towards
yeah.
us.
So when I first met my husband, he used to be so, he would say, I'd be like, you're too touchy-touchy. You say tactile. So he's always trying to, and I'm like, you're too touchy-touchy. Please, you know, and after a while, I just realized I wasn't getting it. I'm like, you're not affectionate. It's like, oh, now you want it. So that's also another thing. Your son is expressing himself, and that's a child. A child is innocent and really doesn't look at your face or your mood. Yeah. He just expresses himself.
The way it comes.
But adults, we tend to look at, is she in a good mood? I mean, we just quarreled yesterday. Is this a good time? So with adults, it's harder to express ourselves because we're afraid of being shut down.
We need to open our phone lines. We're going to call, I think, Taiwa. Taiwa, are you there?
Yes.
Thanks for calling. Morning. Happy Valentine's Day.
Yes, same here. First time caller.
Welcome to the show.
I love you all.
Oh,
we love you too.
My mom's favorite.
Oh.
I just got to say hello.
What are you doing for Valentine's today? What are you doing, Taiwa?
Thank you. I should be home. I'm a student.
Oh, okay. She's a student. She's
saying, doesn't matter. What are you going to do?
And it's true.
What are you doing for yourself today?
Yeah.
Nothing. Just
please take yourself out.
Even if it's to buy shawarma.
Yeah. Take yourself out.
Go to the movies.
Okay, fantastic.
So Andrew is Twitter missing.
What do you do when you're single? Do you have to
come
wait
to that? Let me take a few tweets.
That answers Oluwaseyi Fumi's question. I can only surprise myself at the moment. I'm partnering myself. Andrew says, every time, every day, Valentine messages is important because life is short. You see, this one day we do, we can't wait for it every 365 days in a year, only this one day. So every single day, please, remember. Me too, I've learned to.
I have a classmate, actually, that was saying that every year she buys herself something nice. So we're going to talk about how a single man or woman
do you celebrate
Valentine's Day. Because this, my classmate, Julia, she said, every year she buys herself something really nice and exotic. So she was now going online to see what she would like for Valentine's Day. So we'd like to throw the question out to anybody who is single out there. What are you doing? Hey, you got to show, if you don't love yourself, nobody can really love you the way you like to be loved.
Yeah.
Let me take, I think we have another call. Good morning, are you there? Oh, okay, let's take a few more tweets then.
Yeah, so Kenneth says, good morning all, happy Val. Men are bound by family problems most of the time. They wouldn't be that romantic because of too much family problems on their heads. Thank you all. Kelvin Obolo from Enugu State.
Who is doing something fantastic for their spouse? Please call in. Those are people who want to get to
from. Tell us what you're doing.
Out of the world for your spouse.
We don't want lamentation.
Talk about lament.
We don't want to
learn something nice so that somebody can learn from your own experience.
Please, and it's okay. And it's okay, really, if you don't have the money to do it. See, I love birthday cards. I love Valentine cards.
Flowers.
I just love those sort of things.
No.
Listen, we have people at different points in their lives. Not everybody can afford to shell out monies all the time. So here it is. You can write a lovely note for your wife and put it in her purse. You can walk her down the street to get a bus. You know, maybe usually she do things like that. Tiny things. You can just really look at her, smile at her, and say, I love you.
Take her to a joint, amala joint. Two of you sit down together, share one plate together.
Okay. If you share one plate together.
Share a plate together.
Let me quickly share this.
The little
thing. For me, I want to hear that story, but let me take this call. Good morning. Is it Nima? Halima, thanks for calling. Are you there?
Halima.
Yeah, good morning.
Morning, morning, Halima. Go ahead, please.
I'm a first-time caller.
Welcome to the show.
I should speak to Mariah, who said she wants to dine today.
Yes. Yes.
I think it's not about where your husband takes you to, or I think it's the emotional need of, you know, having the conversation, being together with your husband. It's not about where he takes you to, or what to dine, or what to eat, or something like that. You know, our men are African. Mm. There's this communication gap. Like,
we have to teach
he's there, he takes you for a dinner, but he's on his phone.
Ah.
You know, he's trying to check his account balance, he's transferring money to this person. So he's there, but he's not there.
Yes.
We don't go green. I know that.
You understand my point?
Thank you, Halima, but that's not the kind of person I have.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My husband talks. We have a very good conversation.
Communication.
We have communication is our issue. Mm-hmm. But once in a while, I like to, because I don't even know, because before, when I was single, I tell everybody, every time my girlfriend, Timi Onobolu, we used to paint Lagos red every 2 weeks.
See Lagos,
we are going out,
you finish training on Saturday, you paint Lagos on Sunday, and you are here
to have a conversation.
Don't mind that. I know that was with you.
We need to have a conversation.
Lagos has changed. Now you are going to parties with bros. And all of that. So this evolution takes place. But when it comes to distraction, please, I want to just talk about something. When we go on dates, she mentioned something on the phone. I am a phone person. To save my marriage, what we do is when we go out, I leave the phone in the car. I think sometimes this becomes a major distraction. And if that's what the love you want to give your spouse today is to say, no distractions, I'm giving you the next 1 hour. Anything, throw it on me. Let's just do little things, suggestions.
Mm-hmm. So it's also okay to want different things. We are different people. We have our different love needs. Mm-hmm. So because me, I don't like flowers, I like money, does not invalidate what I want.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And she loves flowers, she doesn't like money, does not mean she's
I
less.
Did not say I don't like
no, I'm
money.
Just giving ex.
Don't use that example.
I'm just giving an example.
can I take Nima's story, please?
It's a long story.
It's a long story. Let me go on a break. We'll come back. We'll take Nima's story. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. Your View will be right back. Welcome back to Your View.
Thanks for staying with us. So Nima was going to say something before the break.
Yes, so I wanted to say, for married women, don't get distracted. So there was this birthday of mine where my husband woke me up in the morning. He prayed, he appreciated me, and it was really a tough time in my marriage. He just went on and on about how valuable, you're priceless, you're everything. And there was no gift. I looked around and was and I got to work. A distraction. Sent me a surprise what this surprise company is. And the woman was wondering, because I went into the wardrobe and made a call, did you send me something? He said, no. It's okay, I'm receiving something now. And then I came out, I was looking at them like this. Please, ladies, you should be really, 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 really careful. Because that drama that she wants might be from that temptation you should avoid.
Oh my God.
Please, just appreciate what is within. Because you see, when the values are where they should be, you would know how to appreciate those small things, and you would certainly not get distracted. By the time you are accepting, and then you are looking, that's how marriages start to shake. Thank God for what you have within. That's the most important thing. I need to take this tweet from Ochi. She's shouting out to her husband, who they watch Your View together. She said, good morning, I'm a first-time texter. I've been trying to call, but he's not connecting. Please, I want you to shout out to my husband. We're always watching TVC together, although he's in the Northeast, serving the country as a military doctor.
Oh, wow.
And then she says, my brown sugar, I love you. Thank you for my vow gift, which means she's received it already.
On her behalf, thank you.
You know, this Nigerian man, the last caller mentioned something like, you know, Nigerian men are not romantic. I think we should change the impression. Every woman wants to be treated nicely. So let's not just peg them, put them in one box that this is how they are crude. Mm-mm, they are not. Because other African women, South Africa, Botswana, Ghana, they always appreciate Nigerian men. They can do anything to have a Nigerian man. Nigerian men, they say, take care of them.
I don't know why
Nigerians
take care of them outside. But
they appreciate the same thing.
They do here.
I think that we shouldn't generalize.
We shouldn't just feel they are not romantic. We have very, I have a romantic husband.
I read BC's messages from my husband and I'm like, yeah.
You're snooping inside it.
He can see, he's seeing.
On a daily basis.
And this feel ugly in my life.
Many children.
You can finish watching the show one day. After watching the show, you just sent my beautiful angel. As in, he just wrote everything. I'm wondering.
Exquisite. As in, what he used for me.
I was like, I had to enter Nima's side and say, don't look at somebody else's grass. Water your own. Because at the end of the day, everybody is speaking their love. It's just that you must notice that they're speaking. They're speaking their love to you.
Yeah.
And most importantly, there's no comparison. You teach your husband how you want to be loved. Let him teach you. And I tell myself, I say, tell me what you want so I will do it. You know, because we take it for granted. I really feel I'm getting older because there's a lot of changes happening in my thinking and all of
I'm
that.
Sure.
So I'm really taking time to appreciate people. And then I'm telling him that I want to appreciate you. I want to do something for you. And let me know how to appreciate you. Because in marriage, it takes effort to cultivate it. But let's not forget ourselves. Single folks, there are many of them out there that they need to do something special today.
Right? So a single folk is saying on Twitter, okay, well, as I single, I'm watching you guys right now. So later I'm going to get a pedicure for myself by myself. My feet are getting Valentine today.
Yeah,
for change. Because usually I just look at the day and look at it as it passes.
Yeah.
But today I think differently.
So we have something special for you this Valentine. Watch this clip and we'll discuss it afterwards. Stay with us.
Surprise, surprise. To my darling wife, Miriam, I know you're probably falling off your seat now, wondering just how I got here. And I'll be very honest with you, that when Balaji first called me, she's persistent and said that the husbands or the ladies of Your View were going to engage in some kind of public display of affection. My first response was, hell no, I don't roll like that. But then it's the season of love, right? I think this is as good a day as any to let the world know, as I shout it loud and clear, just how much I love you, how much I respect you, how I've seen you grow since I met you when you're a little girl. All those years we've been together, you're incredibly special and the best is yet to come. Now, of course, today we share in the grief of the passing of my cousin Stella, but it's still an opportunity for us to share our feelings for one another. You are incredibly special. I'm not sure that I'll be doing this again. This is a one-off. But I'm proud of the steps that you've taken to becoming a really powerful woman, a powerful speaker. And to your co-hosts, Mariah, Tope, Nima, Isi, my sis Yeni, their husbands and Yeni's partner, a happy Valentine's Day. And let me spread this message to Nigerians across the board, even though we're facing one or two challenges. Why don't we share messages of love, not war? I love you, Miriam.
This is so nice.
Oh, this is so nice. Producers, you guys are wonderful. This is beautiful. Okay. Wow.
I didn't expect this.
You know, I asked my husband, did they call you? I don't know. I said, you know, I was saying to you, I'm going to decode this movement at these producers. And I asked him, I said, no, okay. I didn't expect that.
This is so nice.
Yeah, we didn't expect that.
No.
I just saw Brown's picture. I just saw Brown's picture. Oh, my Lord.
Nima Akashat Zibiri. I met my wife far back as 2008. In fact, I leveraged on referral from family. My mother asked me to go to her family house and inquire about one of their daughters. We had a chat in one of these eateries, and I sensed intelligence when we were chatting. That brought me close to her. As time went by, likeness developed into love. And here we are today. I would say that I never regretted meeting Nima as a wife. Some of the qualities Nima has that you just don't have any reason but not to love her are one, her intelligence and her doggedness to stick to what she believes in, and most especially, her Islamic foundation. I want to tell Nima that I love her so much. I wish her all the best in her endeavor. I would want to ask her to continue to do what she's doing and pray Allah guides her. Honey, I love you so much.
It's amazing. Brown. Oh, Nima is.
I am Morayo Afolabi Brown's husband. I've known Morayo for about 10 years, and I would say she's a fantastic person. And today, being Valentine's Day, I would like to remind Mo of the first promise I made her, the very first time we met. The very first time we met was at the Towers karaoke. That was the first time I had physical contact with Moriah. We had been talking on phone before we met. And the song I sang for her that day was A Whole New World. I would like to remind her again and sing her the same song. You've never been. Now that you're way up here, it's crystal clear that you're in a whole new world with me. Happy Vows Day, Moriah.
Yes.
I love romance.
Jehovah.
I do.
Producers, this one, you've actually,
you guys,
you have actually
finished us.
Actually, oh, you're kidding. From our husbands, gifts from our husbands. Are you for real? Are you for real? Our husbands actually sent us gifts.
Wow!
Are you for real? Oh my God, this is your husband has been there. Oh my Lord.
You need to see this gift, guys.
Jesus
this
Christ.
Is good.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
Oh my goodness.
Awesome.
Oh my goodness.
This is awesome.
Why do you really didn't expect this? I actually didn't expect
you got the help.
Peter, I want to chop.
Oh, the hair! I got the hair! Oh my God! I got the hair!
That's some currency being here, baby.
You got money! Money! Let me see, turn around, let me see.
Oh
my Lord!
Oh my God.
Ooh,
awesome, baby. Awesome.
Did I see the name on the wall?
Okay.
So that we can try finish.
Okay.
Zip, I'm getting you this night too. Me, I don't do vow. We never do vow. I'm sure Bola did.
Week.
Week.
Yes, a nice week.
Dora, I'm going to put you to get my transfer.
Me, baby, the rapper and me now. Check it, you are your jealousy story.
I'll let you know.
Okay, we can go together.
So we didn't expect this. The producers kept telling us,
we have a surprise
for you on Friday. We had no idea they were planning this. And this is from your husband. And these gifts are from our husbands. And honestly, on behalf of the ladies, I don't know, guys. I'm short of words.
No, I'm not a diamond and gold person.
Nima, what did you get? You
got bracelets. Because they know. That
oh,
I like.
Wow. Mara, what did you get?
Only one can show.
Cards. You know, I said I love cards. I got chocolates. No, I got a cake.
I got my alcoholic drink.
Jeez.
Oh, I got the cake.
You like that.
Oh, my goodness. You talked about
especially after all the things I got cake. Already.
Your husband got you. And plenty of things.
So, you're discovering me now with this cake. I want to do something.
How do you take this?
This cake down.
Exactly.
I actually do appreciate this. This is beautiful.
This is so
thank you, Brown. Thank you so much. We love you. We love you. Happy Valentine's. Happy Valentine's to our spouses. Happy Valentine's to Tisma, thanks for the clothes. Thank you for the hair, Brown. I mean, I actually asked for hair, and I'm surprised that I got it. I mean, I honestly.
So we have some other.
I was still asking this.
Where will you go and buy?
Thank you.
Oh wow, thank you so much. Okay, so I guess we might have to go on a break because we have a lot to take in.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we do.
That's going to
be a quick
break.
Hyperventilating.
We'll be right back.
Oh, my God.
Okay, I guess there's still more surprise happening, okay? So we're just hanging in and waiting. Oh my Lord.
Oh,
oh my God.
pass? I was watching the door all the time.
How did you pass?
Oh my God.
Did you pass? What have you been there since? You've been around. Oh my Lord, Happy Valley. Oh my goodness. Oh my God.
Very, very surprised.
What am I going to do to you guys? You guys have really gone above and beyond expectations. I don't know.
You people are deep. You're deep.
Honestly.
And they kept saying, oh, something is going to happen. Something is going to happen.
We are short of words. Thank you, Mr. Mark. Thank you very much for being here. Wow.
Thank you.
Talk about, you want to tell him you're grateful for the gifts, cake. Oh, God, we saw the money.
The money.
The cash. The currencies you sent in there because you know your wife. Eh?
Come on, open this.
What's your problem? What's your problem?
Look at her doing like a baby. Yes, I beg, you sit up, my friend. But honestly, we are grateful. Thank you so much, gentlemen, to be here.
Well, let me quickly say thank you to Ziv. Because I know he's very unusual of him. He's not a camera person. He doesn't bother with my job. He stays out of the limelight while I'm shining. Thank you so much. I know you broke some rules to do this. Thank you. I love you so much.
All right, we're going to go to a quick break. When we come back, we'll wrap up. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. Your View will be right back. Welcome back to Your View.
So, our producers lied to us. Several lies that we're having BJ Sachs and we're having Genevieve. Imagine. And we're so excited that, okay, towards the end of the show, we're going to have a special guest. And we're looking forward. I kept looking forward to Genevieve coming today and BJ Sachs. I was wondering
when.
Just for us to get all these. I was surprised. I know I was. And I say thank you to Bumi, Bolaji, Okwe, Dolapo, Mr. Kola, Mr. Musa, and Folari.
Amazing.
Thank you so much, guys.
We love you. I couldn't have guessed this at all.
We didn't guess this.
Thanks for keeping it a secret. I'm pleasantly surprised. Yeah. You guys have done a very good job. And I think that we should love up on you extra.
Definitely.
Love up on you extra. We bash you guys a lot.
I'm still going to bash them because I begged for today off. I needed a day to rest, and they kept saying the way the show was structured, you just have to be on set. You can take forever off.
So my husband calls me FBI, and not for nothing. I am good at just reading people. So I had a feeling that something was going to happen. I asked him this question, and he looked me in the eyes and said,
"Your producers meant to call me."
I just knew that something. So I was really surprised. You guys always have been, you know, just more than producers to us, your family. And this is really thoughtful.
Thank you so much
for just being wonderful people. I really showing us love.
I mean, I saw Brown dressed up and he had a meeting, and I was thinking, why are you dressed up? I said, I don't know, this client is very wonderful. I'm a client I'm meeting for the first time. So when he came out, he gave me the gist about the client. So I was really happy for him that, okay, this new gig coming up. I didn't know he was dressing up for this.
Okay, so you know the dress.
I knew the day he dressed up. I don't mean, I was like, because I knew he was going to say special clients.
I'm
surprised. I'm actually surprised because Brown would have hinted, but he didn't hint about
this. I am even shocked beyond words because I always say he's the one that surprises me the most. He gives me more of the gifts. So this year I was planning to be the one. He even beat me to it.
That money. We are sharing it.
I'm so happy. Thank you so much.
Fantastic. Thank you guys. We had a fabulous time.
Thank you, darling, for coming.
You know, we made this show about us more than you guys.
Nelly says this PDA just gave me chills. I'm self-partnered, but this is an amazing way to appreciate your partner. I'm thinking I'm going to find a significant other.
You have to, my brother.
And he says, husbands, that was beautiful. Myself, one love now. That was beautiful. People are really, really tripping for this. This is really nice.
Quickly, please, let's hurry up.
I want to go and to go and get ready for the other room.
Yeah.
See you on Monday. Bye-bye.
I'm so excited. No, you guys are wonderful.